Hi friends, welcome to my channel. I'm Arpita Karwa, and in this video lecture I'm going to talk about the importance of solving previous year papers. See guys, I've seen so many students that when they start preparing for UGC NET, they order notes, they go to different coaching institutes, they start preparing and reading so many books. But did you ever face this problem that even after reading so many books, going to so many coaching institutes and preparing from other market guides and internet sources, you still were not able to solve questions that came in the UGC NET exam? If yes, then this video is for you, because I will tell you what mistakes most of the people do when they are actually preparing for UGC NET English. Guys, what happens is that whenever we want to approach an exam, and especially a competitive exam, students have this tendency that they pick up a book that is recommended by other people, or they will pick up the book that their friends are reading and they will start reading that book without knowing that what is their aim when they are reading the book. See, you might complete a 400 page book on history of English literature, but still when you are solving the paper, and a paper where majority of the questions are falling from history of English literature, there is a chance, there's a fair chance that you might not be able to answer several questions correctly in spite of reading a 400 page book. I will tell you where the problem lies. Problem lies that without knowing that what kind of questions have been asked in NET exam, we actually dive into the course and we read everything, but we don't know that where to focus and where to not. Guys, have you ever noticed this thing that whenever your teachers were preparing you for 10th board or 12th board exams, they made sure that after chapter, but even before starting a chapter, they used to tell you that this chapter carries so much weightage, then these are the sections which are very important, because every year major questions have been asked from this section. Then whenever they'll start a chapter and they'll keep on reading the chapter, they'll pause and they'll tell you that yahan pe rukna, because this portion was asked in this year's question paper and this was a question which was there in repeatedly 3-4 years. And this is how they used to channelize your preparation, so that when you sit and you study that chapter on your own, you know where to stop, what all points to focus on, what all topics you don't need to focus so much, and what all topics you can leave altogether. So this is how previous year papers help. Also, if you have ever started learning any new skill, for example, if you want to learn cricket, how to play cricket, nobody will tell you ever that read a book on how to play cricket. Or if you want to learn swimming, nobody will ever tell you that read a book on how to swim. People will always recommend you that go dive into the pool and ask the trainer to train you how to swim. Similarly, you go into the field and start playing cricket, and then you'll make mistakes, and over a period of time you'll understand several things about it. The same theory goes with the previous year papers, because when you are preparing from the previous year papers, you are actually looking at the application of what you are studying. Aapne ek writer ko padha hai, but when you look at the previous year papers of that writer, the questions that have been asked from that writer in the previous year paper, you actually know that what all things you need to focus on and how you need to approach that writer. Because course is so vast, guys, that if you try and study all the writers in detail, or you try and get an overview of all the writers, it would be very difficult. Because in my audio course, I teach 700 writers, and those 700 writers have been asked in previous year questions, okay, in previous year papers. So all those 700 writers are important. But then what I do is that I know that what all topics I need to pause on, kin works ko detail mein padhana hai, kin works ke sirf titles yaad hone chahiye, kin works ke kuch references ya important points yaad hone chahiye, that's it. So then we are able to cover the syllabus in 6 months. So this is how we go about with the preparation. In this video, I will talk about three important things. Number one, why previous year papers are important. Number two, from where you can download or get all the previous year papers for UGC NET English. And number three, how to actually solve the previous year paper in order to start your preparation for UGC NET English. So guys, let's begin the journey and let's see how previous year papers will help you in your exam preparation. The first important thing that previous year papers do is that they are able to help you remember better. See guys, our brain is programmed this way that we are able to remember objective questions and answers more easily than a subjective part. For example, I still remember that a week ago, my brother asked me that which is the longest building of the world. And I was not able to give the answer. So he told me that it is Burj Khalifa. Now, it's just 1 week since this thing happened and I still remember the answer, and that is Burj Khalifa. And I'm sure that I will remember this answer if you ask me 1 year after also. But in the morning today, I read a very beautiful article on an interpretation of Mahabharata, but I still don't remember 50% of the thing. I just remember some vague points. And this is how our brain functions. Whenever we read objective type questions and we make a mistake, we are able to remember that answer. If you guys can just remember and, you know, pressurize your brain a bit, you'll remember that if you have given your NET exam, you must have made several mistakes. And in those papers, you still remember the questions in which you failed or in which you marked the wrong answer. That is how our brain functions. Whenever you make a mistake in an objective type question, you are able to remember the answer for a longer period of time. Because jaise hi hum ek mistake karte hain, hamara brain alert ho jata hai. Aur jo mistake humne kari hai, uska answer wo yaad rakhne ki koshish karta hai, because he feels very bad for itself ki okay, I was not able to remember the answers, so now I will make sure ki main wo answer bhoolu nahi. But at the same time, you might read several pages on several important writers. You might read an entire book on Christopher Marlowe, on William Shakespeare. But I bet you that most of the data you will not be able to remember on your exam day. Because jo theory hum padhte hain, wo kahin na kahin hamare dimag mein register nahi hoti. But objective questions bahut jaldi register hote hain. The second thing that previous year paper will help you with is to give you a reality check. Guys, whenever you go through a previous year paper, you will either find questions that horrify you, you would not be able to answer those questions correctly, or you might come across several questions that are very easy for you and you'll be able to answer them correctly, you know, and very easily also. So in both the cases, you will actually get a reality check, because if you're not able to solve the questions, that means you need to change the preparation strategy or you need to work more hard. But if you're able to solve the questions correctly and you're able to answer most of the questions correctly, you will see one important thing that will boost your confidence level. You'll be more confident and you'll enjoy reading about literature more, because when we are successful, we try to do more in which we find our success. The third important thing that previous year papers help us with is that whenever you look at a previous year paper, you somewhere are able to see very similar kind of questions repeating every year in the exam. I have already made two videos. In one video, I've talked about things you must read in a writer or things you must know about an author. And in the second video, I've talked about things you must read in a novel, play or a poem. In both the videos, I have mentioned some really important things that have been asked repeatedly in the previous year paper about a writer. For example, they'll always have one or two questions about Bible, the translation of Bible, Gutenberg Bible, Geneva Bible, King James Bible. So when you look at the previous year paper, you might come across several questions which might come in this year paper as well. So previous year papers help you in knowing certain questions and in knowing a pattern of questions which are repeated every time. They might change the language, they'll twist the language a little bit, and then they will put the same question in the exam. So that is what previous year paper helps you with. Guys, when I started with my UGC NET English preparation, I was facing this major problem that I wanted to download the previous year papers, but I went to so many places. I tried to buy books, guidebooks which had previous year papers. I searched on internet and there was so much confusion regarding the answer key. There were certain books just mein questions the but answers nahi the, toh how to check whether my answer is right or not. Then there were several websites on internet which had the answer key, but they were not authentic, they were not correct. When I used to Google the answer was different from what the website showed. So then I realized realize this thing that it is important that I should make a platform where I can put all the previous year papers for students, so that whenever they begin their preparation, they can look at those previous year paper and then start their preparation accordingly. So you can go to my website www.arpitakarwa.com. Under the section of previous year paper, you will find three heading: paper 1, 2 and 3, and I have uploaded all the previous year papers on those website with answer keys which are authentic. I have double checked the answers from the authentic CBSE website, so you don't need to worry about the answers. Also, if you go on my website, you will find another section called online course content. You will find 10 modules in which I have divided the entire course of English literature, and I have listed all the writers that I cover in my online course. So if you wish, you can join my online course. And even if you're not joining the online course, please have a look at the list, because that list will help you to know what all writers you need to study. I have only listed the writers which are extremely important from NET point of view and which have been asked in the previous year papers. Also, when you're going and looking at the authors, just make sure the headings under which that author falls. I have tried to organize it in a very simple manner so that you have a glance and you are very clear with the course. I've already made a video on the real syllabus of UGC NET. You can refer to that video. That video will help you to know what all things you need to focus and cover if you're preparing for UGC NET English. Also, I would like to mention that when I started my preparation for UGC NET, I also faced one problem. There were people who asked me that you should solve MCQ test series, or you should solve MCQ books which had several questions on different writers. I bought like 3-4 books, and when I was going through that book, I found this problem that those books contained several irrelevant questions. They used to ask about the date when the writer was born, or they used to ask about the date when a book was published, or they used to ask about several things about the writer's biography which was never asked in the UGC NET exam, and they will never ask it because they were certain kind of questions which UGC NET examination doesn't focus on. UGC NET examination focuses on the literary bent of a student, and it focuses on how a student can connect to interconnected things. So you must avoid such guidebooks, or you must avoid certain books which have MCQs, like which has like about 5000 MCQs for English literature, because rather than solving those MCQs, I would prefer that if you solve previous year papers, that would be more beneficial. And I've already talked about the benefits of previous year paper just a few minutes back. So now let's look at from where you can download previous year papers. I've already mentioned that you can go to my website www.arpitakarwa.com. You'll find a tab called previous year paper in which I've uploaded papers 1, paper 2 and paper 3. Paper 1 I've uploaded from 2012. So all the papers from 2012 till date has been uploaded on my website with correct answers. Paper 2 I've uploaded from 2004, and paper 3 I've uploaded from 2012. Paper 3 was subjective before 2012. They used to ask essay type answer questions. So that is why I've not uploaded papers before 2012. But from 2012, they have changed the pattern and they made paper 3 objective. So I've uploaded all the questions and all the papers from 2012 till date. So you can go to my website, you can download the previous year paper and then start your preparation accordingly. So before I end this video, I would like to tell you how you can solve previous year papers and how solving previous year paper will benefit you in your exams. Whenever you come across a previous year paper, first of all, start from question number 1 and start reading the question. You might come across a writer which is unknown to you. For example, you might come across a writer like Robert Greene. You've not studied that writer in your BA or MA course. So in that case, it's your duty that you go to Wikipedia, you go to internet and you search about that writer. At least know a bit about that writer, maybe something about his biography, in what age he belongs, into what country does he belong. For example, if you're talking about Robert Greene and you don't know about this writer, you need to just Google that, who is this writer? So you come to know that he was a university wit who wrote plays and pamphlets during the Elizabethan England, and he was a writer who belonged to Britain. So that's the only information you need to remember. Then you can move to the question that is asked and the work which is mentioned in that question. So if you come across a work which you have not read in your BA and MA, you need to read the summary. That's very important. For example, you come across Kite Runner. Now you know about Khalid Husnaini, but you have never read Kite Runner. Then you must take out time and you must read the summary of Kite Runner from internet or from other sources. And only after knowing the writer and work, then try to attempt the question. Okay. Also, you must remember one very important thing, that whenever you're solving a previous year paper and you've completed that previous year paper, don't just keep that paper aside. You must come to that paper again after 10 or 15 days and try to answer questions one by one again. If you're able to answer 60 to 80% questions correctly, that means you still remember things. But if you are not able to answer the questions correctly, even after solving that paper 10 days ago, you must go and again solve the paper, because revision is the key, friends. Revision will help you to retain information. You might solve 10 previous year papers, but if you don't revise them before your exam, you would lose almost all the data. So that's important. So with that, I end the video. I'll be meeting you in my next video. Do subscribe to my channel, because I post videos every Saturday and every Sunday to help UGC NET English aspirants with their exam preparation. If you like this video, do give it a thumbs up and share it with other NET aspirants. If you have any doubts, any questions, you can write that in the comment section below. Also, you can follow me on various social media platforms where I'm running a Go NET quiz, which is free, and you might get benefit from that quiz because they also talk about objective type questions. Before you leave, I would also like you to go to my website arpitakarwa.com and look at the online course content that I'm offering, and at least make a note of all the writers that you have to study for NET exam. So till the time we meet next, happy learning, keep loving literature, and stay tuned to arpitakarwa.com.